Pastor Luzak. Speaker number two, also speaking from the basic manual, Christine Sneeringer, on what amazing thing happened on this day in history. Toastmaster Sneeringer.
Thank you, Madam. What amazing thing happened on September 13th? We just heard mention of September 11th, and that's really in our minds for the last 11 years. And on September 13th, this year, this day in 2001, that's when America, U.S. air travel restarted, and Osama bin Laden was named as the prime suspect. But there were many other things that happened on this day in history, and I want to share some of them with you. And I want to share, like, my most favorite thing that happened on this day in history, because I think you'll agree with me how remarkable it really was. But first, did you know, for example, that in the 1500s, that on this day in history, Michelangelo began his work on David? In 1788, New York City was named as our nation's capital on this day in history. Right? On this day in history, in 1814, Francis Scott Key wrote the Star Spangled Banner, which we still sing. On this day in history, the Ladies Professional Golf Association was formed in 1949, all you golfers. Also, if Kip were here, he would be excited to know that on this day in history, the first hard disk was invented by IBM. A few other things. The Beatles released the song Yesterday. This is an icon from my childhood. The premiere of Scooby-Doo happened on this day in history. And in 1970, for all you runners and athletes, the first New York City Marathon was run. It attracted 127 competitors who paid $1 each to compete. And on this day in history, Law and Order was debuted. Some of you Law and Order fans. But really for me, I want to share the most important thing that happened on this day in history. And that was in 1944. And that was when Madeline Ruth Baden was born. And that's my mother. Aww. And of course, she did produce some great things. I'm one of them. She had three beautiful children, has three. We're all still living. And one grandchild, and this is a family portrait. I have a brother, older brother, and a younger sister. And that is my father, who that was a tumultuous relationship that ended mercifully when I was in fifth grade. And then she later on married the love of her life, my stepdad, who she's been married to for 32 years. Mm-hmm. A wonderful man who treats her beautifully. I call him every year on their anniversary and say, thank you for being kind to my mother. Mm-hmm. And he says, you always say that. And I say, I'm still grateful. So my mom was a devoted employee of a trucking company, Roadway Express. She worked there for over 30 years, did outstanding work, received recognition for her job. But I want to tell you the fun things about Madeline. I want to tell you what is exciting and interesting about her and why I celebrate this day in history. One is she likes to have fun, and she did pass that on to me, and I probably took it to another level. But she is the perennial sports fan, and her and my stepdad had season tickets for the Buccaneers since 1976 for 30 years. They finally let go of them a couple years ago because they finally said, okay, enough's enough in their later years. But they did love to tailgate every game and just were there through thick and thin, even when it wasn't necessarily worth going to the games. My mother mentioned the LPGA, and she loves golf, and she taught me golf as well. And in fact, golf is how I learned how to drive, because she used to take me, when she went to play golf, she'd take me to drive the golf cart. So I guess I was her caddy, although I didn't really help a whole lot with the clubs, but I did learn how to drive by going through the golf courses of Tampa, Florida, where I'm from. My mother, like I said, is from Alabama. She has a passion for seafood, and we like to enjoy that together whenever possible. She came to town 2 years ago, and we had crab legs. And she loves to spread out newspaper and just, you just eat and you make a mess and you just roll it all up and throw it away. She's got the way to clean house. And she also, my mom is an animal lover, and she passed that on to me. We both have a dog, and she adores her little Jimmy. It's named after her older brother. And this is my mom and Jimmy. My sister lives in Tampa, and so when I go home, we like to do things together. I don't get to see them as often as I would like, but we do like to do girly things. So occasionally we go to the spa, a little bathrobes here. And when we don't make it to the spa, which isn't real often, it's a treat, we just will go to a little salon and get our toes done together. My mom is a very funny lady, and I think I get my sense of humor from her, and I'm grateful for that. She makes me laugh. She's a great cook. She makes a mean martini. Always has one in her hand. Well, maybe not when she wakes up, but she is good at that. And she's also an incredible green thumb. She can grow anything, and I mean anything. And that's the one thing that she didn't pass on to me. I wish that was a genetic thing, and I just didn't seem to get that gene. For example, in high school, when her and my stepdad went out of town, and I was left to take care of the house and water the plants, that was my one job. And so they came back a week later and checked everything out, and everything was still intact. But there was this one plant by the telephone that they asked me about. And it was actually, what drew their attention to it was like the notepad where you take notes. This was back when you had an answer machine, you know, nobody had cell phones. And so the notepad was like, it looked like it had been water damaged. And so she asked me like, what happened? I said, I have no idea. And there was, right next to it was a plant. I said, you told me to water the plants. And she goes, that's a silk plant. So I watered everything that looked like a plant. And so she did not pass that along to me. My mother is very, very patriotic. And the way she demonstrates her patriotism is that she is committed to boosting the U.S. economy. And so every year on Black Friday, she goes out and she shops. She gets up before God and she shops. And I always love to find what she got for me. She also can drive a stick shift, which she did pass on to me, and I still drive one to this day. And so my mother is one of my favorite people, and I do celebrate her birthday. And I just want to close with this poem for her. Roses are red, violets are blue. Were it not for you, I wouldn't be here too. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you. Please mark your comments for Toastmaster Sneeringer.